we are very happy to have with us the legendary footballer Sri Sohail Manna in our studios. And I am M.A. Sattar, an ex-footballer, and I played football with him for many years.
Yes, I have also played football with Sattar for a longer period, not in the same team, but in a different team. So we are definitely, we can consider ourselves as a very close each other in a different situation, you see, that made us very helpful.
Tell us how the radio popularized football in the past.
At that time, there is no TV. At that time, we all depend on the radio. And it helps a lot, not only to listeners, but it helps a lot to the players also for their, for the raising their standard of football.
Tell us about your childhood.
Sattar, for us, you are aware that during our period, there was no other game than football. So we used to play football during our childhood.
Which school did you attend?
That is Madam Madhusudan Pachaudhary School, because I was living at Howrah. So there, Madam Madhusudan was very close to my residence. At that time, there was a one-hour drill, you see. We attended drill, but the school teachers also, the game teachers also very much like the football game also. So after the school period is over, we had the coach, I mean the game teacher, took us to the field, because there is the school always situated very close to a small field. We used to play football there. So we have actually started playing football from our school career. Actually, from the school career, I have started playing football. That means I have started my career from school, Madhusudan Pachaudhary School. And then I studied in the Narsinanda College in Howrah. When I was 14 years old, I was studying in school and played football. At that time, of course, there was no other game than football is there. Because I used to play little bit of football than any boys. So teacher also took much, interest about me. Study also is there. We have to maintain our study definitely, because we have to make a matriculation pass also. So that means I have to study something, not that only we have to play football and no, we do not follow any study and all these things. Playground was very close to the school. Otherwise, during the school period, how did you manage to play football?
How much support did you get from your family?
Very much. I think without the help of the family members, I don't think I could have reached to this area to which the football career gave me the chance. Actually, I was living with the maternal uncle's family. So I'm not very much connected with my mother and father.
Parents.
My father also used to play football. And they used to play football also. And they were living about a few miles away from here. Because I was in Howrah and they live in Hooghly district, Ramanathpur village. Because from the boyhood, I was there. So I did not know, I can't give you the answer about it, that how, why I was maintained by the Metanangas family. I have one brother, that means we two brothers together and two sisters. We have the four members of the family, I think. Definitely, I can boldly say that due to my maternal uncle's support, I used to play, not only used to play, whatever the honor I got it in my career, that is due to my maternal uncles.
Which club did you play in the beginning?
Howrah Indian Club. That is Howrah, because I used to live in Howrah. 14 years old. After that, I joined Mohunbagan Club at the age of 18.
When did you join Mohunbagan?
In the year 1942, when I was 18 years old. I was born in 1924. So when I was 18 years old, I started playing for Mohunbagan Club. Impressively, at that time, you know, that actually general must, you see, loves Mohunbagan Club at that time, during that time. The Mohunbagan Club, traditionally, they are known that they fought against the British rule and we earned freedom because of the football maidan.
You and Mohunbagan were inseparable for a long period. So let us talk about it. Mohunbagan was a big name in those days and you were too young. What was your feeling then? Fear, joy or anything else?
Mohunbagan Club at that time was favorite players or favorite team of the All India team, All India people. So naturally, I had no other alternative but to play for Mohunbagan Club, because my uncles are all engaged with Mohunbagan Club as an officer. Because at that time, perhaps you are aware that Mohunbagan Club has a name that they played, they won against the British team, and that's why the feelings were they can beat the British team, so we can get their freedom from the Britishers.
At Mohun Bagan, when you got the first chance to play?
It was the year in 1942. In the year 1942, when I was an 18 years old boy. Only 2 years I waited for. 2 years means at that time, we had no other alternative but to play for Mohun Bagan Cup, because our uncles, I was maintained by our family. But uncles, they are all belong to the Mohun Bagan Club. So we had no other alternative but to play for Mohun Bagan Club. So very first year, we got the chance to play for few matches, not all the matches.
Then
subsequently from 1943-42, I started playing football for all the matches. But actually, you can accept it 42, because 42, my career, at that too, on that particular day, 42, I played for few matches. That means that 8 to 10 matches, not that very small match, one or two matches.
Okay. Who was the coach of Mohun Bagan Club those days?
Those days, you know, football coach and, you know, and the physical coaches are same. Our coaches were the B.D. Chatterjee. Baleda, because I got that training from Baleda in the beginning, so naturally my feelings of Baleda will be there. Baleda mostly he used to give more importance to the physical ability, physical fitness. So he gave all these physical trainings and all these things during the progress of the football training system. But not then, physical fitness is always better. Baleda is not very habituated with this practical system and all. But physically, he used to give us the training, and practical training we used to get from senior players only at the time. About the football and practical, that we used to get from senior players of the Mohun Bagan Cup. At the time, senior, there are a lot of senior players there.
What about the environment those days?
No, no, means that was, environment is definitely very much helpful to player and play both, because there's not much money at the time. Only thing you can play, because if you play for Mohun Bagan Club, the people will come to know that Shailen Manna belongs to Mohun Bagan Club and he's playing for Mohun Bagan Club. That's all. Nothing else. I took money from Mohun Bagan Club in the year 42 and 19 rupees only. Because Balaida asked me, Dhirendra at the time, Dhirendra.
Dhirendra
asked me, Manna, how much money you require? I said, how much money means? Well, you see, at the time the tram was there, and yes. Tram fare and bus fare, how much money? I said 19 rupees. Totally, I calculated and said 19 rupees it comes. So, Dhirendra asked the treasurer to pay 19 rupees only, not 20 rupees.
Did you get any financial help from the club in the following years?
No, I don't think. I did not accept any financial assistance from Mohun Bagan Club.
Why?
Because I did not feel much, because I was staying in the maternal uncle's family. My uncle is very much connected to the Mohun Bagan Cup, and I am taking money from the Mohun Bagan Cup. That is very insulting to the family, you see. And to play for Mohun Bagan Cup is an honor, definitely.
Can you tell us something about the rivalry between Mohun Bagan and East Bengal in those days?
There was, because Mohun Bagan, East Bengal, there was all the time there was a rivalry. About why this rivalry, I cannot say. It is difficult for me to say. But the rivalry was there. Doesn't mean that we'll fight all the time against on the ground. That is not there. Rivalry means East Bengal tried to score more goals against Mohun Bagan, and Mohun Bagan tries to score more goals to East Bengal.
And your performance against East Bengal, how was it?
Satya, at least I have tried my best to play better football against East Bengal club all the time. Whether we will win or lose, that's in material. But I must play better football.
As far as the charity match is concerned between Mohun Bagan and East Bengal, what were your feelings?
No, Satyari, perhaps you are aware that I don't have all these feelings very much before playing the big matches. What the general players, they do have some feelings, but I don't have that.
You remember very well that whenever we used to play the charity match against East Bengal, we used to stay in the Talkie House. You remember?
But I remember the players used to stay in the Talkie House, but I don't go. I was always coming from my house, residence.
Achha, except you, the other players used to stay there.
Other players used to stay in the hotel because they have to collect in several places. But I always used to come from my own residence. Actually, I don't have that feeling, you see. That means whatever the players feel much, If they feel mad, they will be nervous. So I avoid all these things.
Now, can you tell me, when did you become the captain of the club?
I started captaincy for in the year 1950.
How long?
And continued for 6 years. That means 55.
Can you tell us about your experience as the football captain
of the club?
Of the club, and then for the country?
Both the captaincy requires a great responsibility. I never got so much excited when I was the captain of the Mohan Bagan team. But I was very serious when I captained the Indian team also.
Manna, can you tell us about your captaincy you did for the country?
Satya, perhaps I don't know whether I am incorrect, but I did captaincy for country in the one Olympic Games, three quadrangular tournaments, as well as Asian Games. These 4-5 times I did the captaincy of the country. And success, I can't say in details that what are the successes there. I did the captaincy for all this.
Asian Games.
Asian Games,
yes.
First Asian Games. Asian Games, India, Pakistan, Burma, Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka. That's the quadrangular tournament. But Asian Games, we played against only Golden Age Warriors.
Yes.
Now, it was held in Delhi.
Yes.
Pandit Nehru was present on the ground. And he came to the ground to receive us. That's a great honor for
and
us.
And his daughter was also with him.
Indira Gandhi also was there. So that was a memorable day. We could not forget about it.
Yes.
That is a gallant experience. Because of the game played in Delhi and in front of our Prime Minister. As a footballer, I've got various statements up there, perhaps you are aware, that I enjoyed all these things, playing football, playing all these tournaments, and receiving gold medals, having won the tournaments. So there is a great honor, I think, I feel. And it is also a certain Shatthar that it's a great honor which I receive. I feel that I've been a very honored person in India as a football player.
You know very well that we played the quadrangular and for 4 years, and we were the champions.
And 4 years, no, 3 years.
No, 4 years.
Because four teams, India, Pakistan, Burma, Sri Lanka, played for 3 years. Four teams, 3 years. We played all the times, we won the tournament. There was Amit Khan also
Amit
was
Khan,
there.
Amit Khan was also
Raman
there.
Also on Venkatesh was there. The forward lines, particularly the forward lines were at the time is very good.
Very
I
good.
And because both of you played inside left, sometimes I used to play
right in, and he used
Shatthar
to play
Shatthar left in.
He played left in, I used to play
right in.
Those days we used to play for five forwards.
He had to play right in because of Amit Khan. Because Amit Khan, he could not play the other position only.
I could play both right in and left in.
Amit Khan is rigidly, he is a left in side player. So he used to maintain Shatthar was a right in player.
Who were your favorite players those days?
Shatthar, there are a number of players in favorite, I can say definitely. But I do not want to say anything about it, who is the particular player's favorite about me, because it goes against our other colleagues also.
Oh,
so
yes,
I don't
naturally.
Like 4-5 minutes, one number comes in Amit Khan definitely.
Yes.
And you also, Shatthar also. And Venkatesh also.
Oh, Venkatesh, yes.
Who was supposed to be the best winger at the time. Yeah. So I have to name all these persons practically. Panchu Pandu is Venkatesh. Venkatesh. Only Shatthar out.
No, Venkatesh, Apparao, Dhanraj,
Amit Khan,
Saleh.
All these players. Except Apparao, all of them are purposely played for the Indian
team.
For the country, all of them.
Kindly tell us about your free kick, which is very famous those days.
No, any sort, it's very difficult to explain or describe how we used to be. It was happened. I can say, but it has happened by me because I can swap the ball also. Ball swarming, it goes, you see, I can't say how this ball was so much swapped when I did the kick. It is very difficult for me to describe it. One match against, yes, and that is decided because we are 1 point down by possibly the
league match
in the East Bengal. Possibly, he was the East Bengal or Rajasthan.
I think
we were one point down.
Against Rajasthan.
Rajasthan. We have to win the match. So I scored the goal from free kick, just about 5-10 minutes left, about the match completed. Now that means, you know, my free kick shot, what it affected the goalkeeper is because it swerved so much ball.
Yes.
It goes straight, suddenly it swerves.
After a certain distance, he used to swerve.
So naturally the goalkeeper possibly deceived, because he could not expect the ball so much will be swerved, so that he is just standing to receive the ball. Certainly ball goes out somewhere else. It is very difficult for him to anticipate this. Yes, I did practice sometimes, because it requires a practice also for swerving the ball, because of course swerving the ball during our time was very easy because of the
barefooted football. Yes, naturally. Achha, can you tell us about your experience in the foreign countries?
No, that is, you have to call it about 48 Olympic Games.
48,
when
yes.
When we used to London. London. And it was the first time Indian team visited to London
for
playing Olympic Games.
Yes.
So in the year 1948. So that was very important for us also. And we played also very good game.
We missed two penalties, missing two penalties.
But the important thing was, we were allowed to play with barefoot, without boots, in London. And 9 of our players played without boots.
At 48.
Two of our players, that is Papin and another Bombay players, Parab. They were booted players. So 9 of players of Indian team played without boots, and two played with boots on. So that gives us much support from the supporters of the local people. They give us tremendous support. And with their support, we played also a very good match against France. And that result was, that's how we won the match. But the next day, we lost against Sweden. It was, we lost in the first match.
First match against Yugoslavia. By a big margin.
By a very big margin.
10-1.
That is because, you see.
And with the climate also.
The climate was very against us, very much against us.
Tremendous win in the ground when we took the field.
We were playing barefooted.
And
after 1952, boots were made compulsory from 53.
Because of that.
Yes, because of that.
It's snowing, you see. All the time, whole ground, you'll see that it's snowing. We are playing in the barefoot.
Drizzling, snow drizzling.
It is impossible for.
What are your food habits?
Food habits, you know, that generally, particularly the Bengali people, they like to rice very much. I do not take rice in the day of the match. I did not. Still now, I am maintaining this formula. I did not take rice much. Only once or 2 days in a I took rice, you know. Habit means it is original. I can spend a day with a two pieces of bread.
Only?
Even if I don't get anything to eat, if I have 2 pieces of bread, a little bit of cheese or butter, I can continue. I like food of chapati, parota, this type of food I like. And with this, curries. You know, with potato, I used to take potato very much.
Rice you don't like?
Rice I don't like. Still now I don't take rice all the weeks. Only 2 days. Even if I go to some function somewhere else, I told them that don't bring rice to me. I can have vegetable,
yes,
and also the non-veg. It's all right. Vegetable also, you know, sometimes I feel the vegetables are very good. At least in the day of the match, I used to take vegetables. Likely. But still I take meat and fish, everything. Actually, it is difficult for me to describe the chicken or fish, which I like it. But I do take, even in the morning if I get a fish, in the evening I can get a chicken. So there is no easy like or dislike question that arises. Vegetables, that means any curry with potatoes, very much I like it. And also, you know, the brinjal. Fried brinjal, I like it. Or boiled brinjal, I very much like it. Egg I do take. But I avoid taking egg nowadays because in the old age, sometimes it is doctors suggested that don't take so much egg. Milk I do take. Every night I must have milk.
Do you take tea?
No, I don't take tea. Not at all.
Not at all either.
Fruit I like. Whenever I go, at least this banana and orange, I like it. The people say whether you don't like the apple. Apple I seldom used to get because during our period the apple was very costly. But Vedana is also troublesome to
banana.
To get Vedana.
Oh, Vedana, what's a Vedana?
You see, because if you like to have a banana, that banana's juice is better. Juice is, yes. If you can have a juice from Vedana, I can have it.
That would be.
Manab, I want to know whether foreign coaches are necessary in our country.
I think it is still necessary for us because first of all, they will have more command than our local players and local coaches. That is very much important. Commanding from a coach to their players is very much necessary. Technical supremacy also.
Mainly it is technical
supremacy also.
Modern methods
and all these things, they have to adopt it.
What are the good qualities of a good footballer?
He must be a very disciplined man. He must know the technical parts of the game. Because suppose if he can't demonstrate how to take a good shot, how to head a good head. So he must know it in details. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for any coach to give the coaching in particularly. Because head means, this is head. Head means you have to forehead. Use only forehead.
Forehead.
So that should be described before they are coaching. It's very difficult to say, but I can, what is it, as a defender, I can say
yes.
A defender means he must be very much knowledgeable about the game and opponent forward lines when they started playing. He must be very much concerned with the foreign players because defenders has to defend the team.
Defend the team.
Not to allow the opponent forwards to score a goal. So they have to understand, for the defenders, they must be very understanding from each other. Otherwise, you see, it's very difficult for them to control the, you see, opponent forwards because if they are big, big forwards, they can adjust the system also. If they started playing with three backs, when they find that their forward lines are much better, they can start to four backs nowadays. So it depends on the opponent's strategy. Strategy is the opponent forward lines capacity. You must know the, first of all, qualities mean, practical qualities is he must be a good header.
Yeah.
He must be a good tackler.
Yeah.
He must be a good shooter. All these things depend on defender.
Then I
think anticipation is very much necessary.
Anticipation is very essential.
Anticipation is very much necessary in our time also.
Yes. Yeah.
Because nowadays, I tell you, we are playing with so much defenders. Anticipation question is doesn't arise. Because nowadays, 4-2-4, 4-4-4, like this, we are playing. So anticipation possibly to go where?
So I think
we played with two backs. We need anticipation. And now they are having four backs. They don't have any anticipation. They don't need any anticipation. Only positional. Only they know that if they attack from the right side, left back goes to oppose the attack. And you must cover this right back. This is the thing is necessary only. But in our time, the two-back system is very much necessary was anticipation and positional game. Then nowadays, tackling also is there because we are playing more defenders. And we are playing with boots on.
Yes.
So previously, we played with barefooted. Our tackling was very difficult.
Nowadays, you see, there are only two forwards. All are defenders. Others are defenders.
Definitely. Football is always a tough. Rap, I don't consider.
Tough.
It must be tough. So rap, defender should avoid the rap tackle. Now idols means previously I said Gustavo or idols.
Yes,
Gustavo. I haven't seen neither Gustavo nor Evan Chandler.
Yes.
And I'm the idol. These fullbacks were 1911 Mohunbagan Club's Revan Chatterjee.
Yes.
He used to play football also, but he was a booted player. Revan Chatterjee played with boots on. There are quite a number of defenders now playing, you see. But tell you, nowadays defenders' job becoming more easier because they are playing with four backs, four halves and two forwards. Sometimes they are playing with five backs, three halves, two forwards. So nowadays they are keeping forwards with less number of forwards, but defenders most they are keeping more players in their defense.
The present
so that nowadays what is their strategy? They should not concede goal.
Yes, that is
if they can score one goal, they will win the match. That is I hesitate to speak because there are so many defenders in our country nowadays.
But you it's have very your own likings.
Because I don't, I avoid this
Acha, can you kindly tell us about the positioning of players who play the game? I do mean the positional role of the players.
Positional players is absolutely necessary. Because if we don't have the defenders or the forwards, it must be mentioned really it is necessary. Because forward lines, generally they do score goals, and defender they do save the goals and or defending the team. During our time, two defenders means there are two backs, three ups and five forwards. So naturally, two backs means they have to roll it whole off the ground.
Yes.
They have to. And they actually, according to the position of the opponent team's attack, so they have to take a lot of energy, you see, to play football during those time as a two backs. Very difficult for them to continue for 90 minutes. It's a hell of a job. So I got the experience because I used to play the first Olympic Games of the two-back system. So naturally, it is very difficult to maintain the good result playing a two-back system. Defenders are things in the tackling and the heading. Also, they must be a good shooter, long shooter.
Overlapping is this.
Overlapping defenders is another two-back system. Absolutely.
When we go for the attack, the defender should adjust himself according to the situation and go for the
but
attack.
But at that time, they can't go for attack. Two backs go for attack. Never. Because at that time, it was not necessary, Shatta, to go for attack. Because we have five forwards, three halves, and two defenders.
Yeah, naturally, yes.
So the five forwards, their three halves are there. They can give a support to the five forwards.
During our that time, means, we used to play two-back system.
That means five. So defense, two backs, we should not go to the attacking side.
Do we feel any difference today in today's game?
Definitely, defending part actually to nowadays. All I can say that the teams adopted a very defensive system nowadays. That's true. But then you also see that we are having four defenders or sometimes five defenders are there. So naturally, we are defending. You see, because the team do not want, but coaches do not want that their team concede goals.
And lose.
Defense means nowadays the coaches they have adopted the defense system. They also think that we should not concede goal. If we score one goal in the 90 minutes games, we'll win. So why should I score a goal? Concede goal. Concede goals means we'll have difficulty to score two goals.
So naturally,
they are maintaining the defensive system nowadays.
Manna, as you know, the job of the defenders nowadays has become more easier because there are more
players
in the defense. On the other hand, the job becomes difficult as technical evolution like video recording catches the weakness or the strong point of the defender. What do you think?
Yes, that's easier because of the TV. TV, the players can follow the opponent system and all these things, so it is become easier to attend their defense system. That is definitely nowadays it is more easier for them to defend.
Because more people are in the defense.
More people are in the defense. That was is very easier for the defenders to tackle the opponent forwards.
Manna, I want to know one thing, which is greater, system or the player?
The player is definitely greater because player has to adopt the system.
Naturally.
Not that the system has to follow the players.
The system is flexible.
If you can change the system during the progress of the match. So system, you see, you have to adopt opponent.
According to the merit of the team. Can you tell us about the adoption of sports medicine today?
Shatar, I have a little knowledge about it. Honestly speaking, because during our time, you know, there is no such medicine.
I do agree
which
with
will
you.
Give you the medicine and you play football.
No such thing.
Even in the beginning, I tell you, the coaches used to avoid giving a tablet to the players because he doesn't know what is the effect of the tablets in the players during the progress of the game. The sports medicine definitely helps there because
there are
some things which will be very helpful to the players, at least on the ground, you see, if the coach can adopt the sports medicine.
How early should a player start playing?
How early? At the age of 14 years, definitely, they should start.
no view that.
At least 12 years, you can just, the idea of the football, you see, you can do it. But not that. You can kick. A football player needs a kicking strength. So unless he reaches to the certain age, at least 13, 14 years old, he can't, you see, even he can't shoot the player.
Yeah, naturally, I do agree with you. Manna, can you kindly tell me what is your idea about spotting, hunting for the talent?
That is very difficult to say. Because it is difficult to say because it needs a practical thing. You know, you must be on the ground, players are practicing. Then you can, after watching their play, then you can decide this, you see, the dependency system.
Naturally, I do agree with you.
It's not possible through my kind of thing to decide all these things. A junior is definitely, hunting out talents must be ensured in the junior age.
Very essential, very necessary.
At least from, I feel for football, at least at the age of 14, you must be.
Manna, I want to know, what is your idea about grooming a player?
Idea means grooming a player is a very difficult job, you must know. Because grooming a player, a coach, unless he is very serious enough of it, it is very difficult. Because they depend on your grooming, idea. How do they be expert in good shooting, good heading, good control the ball. So these are all technical things. It is very difficult task to groom a player within a very short period. So it takes a longer time to groom a player, I tell you. And that is also, the grooming a player is also difficult for a coach. And coach also should know the subject correctly, what is grooming the players. At the time, we have no such system, no such all these things. We had to go for a senior players' activities. How Gusto Babu used to take a shot, I have to follow that. And Gusto was a barefooted player.
Our time there was then
I have to find Revan Chatterjee, how he used to take a shot because he was a booted player. So technique is entirely different, barefooted and booted. Don't forget. I know that because I played with both the system. I played with barefooted football, I played with boots on. So I know if I want to take a good shot, barefooted football technique is entirely different from the booted football. So system is changing according to your adoption of something else.
What should be the ideal habit of a good footballer? Yeah, food habit of a good footballer.
Satar, I do not know correctly because it depends on the doctor or those who are, you see, thinking of these things. I am not that way. I prefer those who want to play football, they must avoid starch food. That's, I tell you, I don't use
rich food. Rich food, they should.
Starch and rich.
Oily,
starch
spicy.
Means malt. Why avoid taking rice? Because it's completely starch food. So these are the food habits you must develop. You can have a starch food, about 2-3 days you don't have any game. You can just test it and do it. But during your career, when you used to play football regularly, you should avoid all this. And you bring a food habit, the dry food you take chapati. And foreign countries, they take bread. Bread and milk also is a little heavy, I tell you. They don't take milk in the foreign country. They have some sort of, what is that? I don't know. Some sort of things, they're liquid. But they don't drink any fat. Because milk is fully fat. So they don't take milk. In the foreign country, there is seldom people used to take milk. They take tea without milk.
Without milk, yes, without I know milk. The tea with.
So why? Because they think that milk is definitely help you to get fat.
Rich in vitamins.
Rich
in vitamins.
So these are the things you have to maintain. I did not take rice in the day of match. Why? Because it will make me unfit. Heavy.
Dozy.
But Gusto used to play with sufficient quantity of food, rice. He used to take so much rice. At that time, there was no such system. The day of the match, you take early food. Rice or eat whatever it is. That was their habit. But nowadays, the players are not, taking a rice in the day.
They are not permitted to take rice.
They are not permitted. Is the coach? Yes, they are not permitted. So this, according to the system of food, system of game also been changed. Food habits is changed and system also changed.
Yes.
Diet is very much important, particularly for football
players. Yes, it is very important.
Very important. Diet and regularity, because you go to bed early. It is very necessary for the football, particularly for the football players, because football. Why should I mention the football players? Because football players need so much physical fitness. I don't think any other game needs that football fitness. Hockey also there, but hockey is necessary because hockey you have to play with a stick on, but football you have to play with body.
With your foot body.
Body. Football means body. In every game, body is important. But nowadays, you know, if you consider the cricket match, previously cricket players were, what was their body? You consider like nowadays what Sourav Ganguly is doing?
Yes.
Gymnastic, he made a gymnastic. Because you know that unless the player keeps his body very fit, he can't play in any games, he cannot play. Because you have to run. In the cricket, you have to run towards it. You have to take a shot whenever you fit. If you are not fit, you cannot take all these things. So fitness is necessary for every match.
Fitness is very important in all matches. What do you think of football in India? What is the standard of football in India now?
Sattar, I can tell you it's very difficult to make comments on this matter, on this subject.
No, but as you're an ex-Olympic captain,
Sattar, you can expect it.
How can we improve on this?
Improve on this? I tell you, first of all, you have to maintain your physique properly. Then you have to go to the coaches, those who know how to play good football. You must have the idea from the coaches. And then you can improve your football game. And you must give sufficient time for this. Sufficient time, you must have a sufficient time to have a coaching from the coaches.
First of all, we should have talent hunting. We should pick up junior boys, younger boys from...
I fully agree with you.
Yes.
Because unless you have the junior boys, whom you would coaching the coach.
We should start from the younger age.
Definitely.
Because we can adjust the flexibility according 14, to...
That should be 14 to 15 years old boys.
Yes. We should have long-time planning and we should try to engage foreign coach for this purpose.
Obviously, it is required. And long-term question is required because, Sattar, unless you have a long-term program, you can't give them a proper coaching.
Yes, naturally.
Coaching is a very big subject.
Is it? Yes.
Longest period.
Longest period.
And 5 to 10 years training camp means, what will be their study?
What about their studies?
Yes,
we should look...
There's a problem. No guardian will allow their kids to go for football coaching only. 10 years is too much.
5 years, if it is.
Yes, 5 years.
Then
junior, at the age of 15, 10 years, 5 years, 20 years old.
Yes, yes.
And he'll be all right. 20 years, he can play first division football. Playing what for the country, unless you join any team, you have no chance to play for the country. You must attend one good team. And coaching will be there. And then they will be able to play football for the country. Foreign coaches. Necessary. But nowadays we are not depending on foreign coaches too much. But
we are not depending, nowadays we are not depending on foreign coaches. We have a lot of Indian coaches.
Yes.
Who can do good training.
Foreign coaches also must be English man.
English.
And he must know the English.
You
have a good foreign coach, Sweden from you can
European countries.
Other European
that will not help us. The foreign coach should know English.
English
necessary. Yes, yes. I come to another question. Whether we should give preference to the club or the country?
Yes.
Or the players?
I believe that we give more preference to the country first, then the club. Of course, the club has the capacity to wing the players, no doubt about it. But the question of country, when it comes, we give more preference to the country.
Naturally, I do agree with you. Should we play more Europe and foreign matches in other countries for the exposure of the players?
Yes, definitely, it's very much necessary. Unless you give exposure to the players to the foreign against the foreign teams, it is very difficult for them to play in international matches. So, if you want to make the team all right for playing in international matches for success of the country in football, these sort of things are necessary.
Achha, do you think we should create an academy and infrastructure?
Infrastructure is definitely necessary. Mm. Without infrastructure, you cannot move an inch. Infrastructure means there should be, first of all, there should be a coach. Then the other materials which will help to the players for the development of their muscles, their power of football, these sorts of things. There are some machinery also. These sorts of things are necessary for any training. If you go to the training, really a training system, then you need all these things, the infrastructure. You know, this is the one word. But you need so many things,
yes,
for completing infrastructure.
Academy
also necessary. I can tell you the infrastructure is much necessary than academy.
Yes, sir.
If you keep infrastructure there, if you place keep it somewhere else, and you just invite the players, they will go there. But academy is such a question, is a very big word, academy. But I do not think the academy will be so much helpful without the infrastructure.
I think that academy is also part of infrastructure.
It's a part of infrastructure.
Yes, part of
infrastructure. That means you can say the any infrastructure, academy, whatever call it, academy. Academy is one kind of
Achha, what do you think about the financial and social security of the players?
That is necessary, Sattaru. Unless you have the financial assistance, you cannot do anything about it. Whatever you think about the, you can run this academy and all this. Unless you have the financial assistance.
Social security, financial security, you must have. I do agree with you.
Then what kind of financial or social aid do you mean?
Financial aid to my money. There must be agent who can help you in this matter. Financial help.
Achha, Manna, I would like to know about the National Football League. Whether it will help to improve the Indian football standard?
Certainly it will help in the Indian football standard, because if the players will have an opportunity to play different type of footballers and football schemes also, system also, different states, they play different type of football, better knowledge in this football. This will definitely help the improvement of football for national, after adopting national football competition.
Manna, I would like to know your opinion about the foreign footballers.
I think it is not bad system that if we bring the foreign players from the foreign country, because our players will definitely improve their standard also playing football against them.
Exchanging the ideas.
Of course, the technique we have taken, definitely our players will learn football from them. If we bring quality of football players in the foreign country, our players definitely will be benefited after playing against them or in favor of them.
Manna, can you kindly throw some light on the honors and awards you received from the government?
Private, I don't know, but government means I got the honor from the government, that is Padmashri, is a government honor. Another honor I have received, that I have been selected by the All India Football Federation as a best footballer of the century.
Yes.
These are two things. Otherwise, what else I have done? Yes. And Mohanman Cup also made me a player of destiny. They have made a destiny in my name.
This is also a great honor.
Yes, because naming a road in my year is a great honor for me.
Definitely.
I don't give much importance to it, honestly speaking. And they have given me, definitely it's a great honor. I feel it. But I don't give any much importance to all these things.